Hey everyone, Matt here from Doctors of Running. Today we're going to do a review, a video review of the Saucony Endorphin Shift 2. I would encourage you to go watch David's review where he compares the speed and starts talking a little bit about the pro as well. We'll have full written reviews of all three of these shoes coming up here. I can't speak today. And I'd encourage you to look at both. We all have different opinions about these. We're all different runners, so please take a look at all of them to let us know what you think. So today is the Shift 2. The Shift was one of my favorites of the original Endorphin series. It's a great training shoe. It's very protective. It's very much a maximalist shoe. Doesn't use the PIBA foam that the other two, the Speed and the Pro are using, but it's still a great shoe. The rocker is in full effect here. This version was supposed to be a upper update. This is the training shoe of the series, including the Speed and the Pro 2. But it doesn't feel like just an upper update. There's some other changes that occurred, and I think some people are going to be happy with that. Biggest thing let's start with specs. So men's size 9 comes in at 10.4 ounces. Women's size 8 comes in at 9.2 ounces. There's still a 4 millimeter drop. It's a 38 millimeter in the heel, 34 millimeter in the forefoot. I'm just double checking my numbers here. And this is, again, more of a structured, cushioned ride. They actually, in some of the things, call it, like, you know, so there is some stability to it. Not in a, like, posted manner, but there is some structure to the shoe that those that need a little bit more stability are going to do really well in this shoe. Those people who don't want any stability, know the ride might be a little bit stiffer for you, but there's no post or anything that's going to really push in your foot. So it should work for a large variety of runners. Starting with the big changes, obviously the first thing you can see is the heel clip here, not including the color changes. There's an external heel counter here, which does really well for me because I don't like these things. They tend to irritate my Achilles, and I actually just had a mild Achilles irritation recently just because of some stupid stuff I was doing over training, which is my fault. But I can't feel it at all in this. It feels really good. It still stabilizes me really well. And what I liked about the last version is that it dropped down and almost acts like it's not a post, but it drops down far enough that it provides a little bit of guidance, especially for those that need a little bit more medial. I don't know what to call this. Like I already said guidance, right? It's hard to use another word, but just a little guidance along the ways. What I also really like about the shoe is that this heel counter extends on both the lateral and the medial side. So those people that go either direction, it's going to keep you in the middle. And that's what a stability shoe should do, or any shoe should help try to keep you along the lines of where you move best and not too far in either direction. A lot of shoes will tend to push people in one way more than the other. It's nice when you have something that keeps you centered on the platform. So still works really well. Less bulky than the last version, but does a great job of locking the heel in without being bulky and causing an irritation on the Achilles, and definitely helps guide through. Other thing that they've really changed, upper is still very breathable, but there's more structure to it now. So the last version I liked, it felt though that I was going to slip off the platform whenever I turned. There wasn't a lot of structure through here. It was very open, very flexible mesh. This is different. So there's now additional mesh here, a little laminated, little stitching here on both the lateral and the medial side. These almost act like little sidewalls along the way. It's not that aggressive, but it's enough that's like, oh, this is kind of nice. Not a shoe you're going to want to wear sockless. I can feel the stitching on the inside, but with socks, you'll be totally fine. So didn't wear these sockless. Although this like heel collar stuff is super comfortable, but this is on the inside too, so I wouldn't want that. But it definitely helps lock the foot in. So this upper feels more secure than the previous version for sure. Doesn't feel any more narrow, which is something I was worried about. It just feels more secure. And that seems to be the big thing along the line as well. David might mention this in the Speed too. I am actually able to train in the Speed for the first time. This review is not about the Speed. We'll get that. Check out David's review. This is about the Shift 2. So the whole thing feels much more secure, still really breathable. Laces are nice, as I didn't have to lace lock this shoe at all. And the laces stay really nice and tight. So they're anti-slip laces, really good. The tongue is gusseted, so it locks in really well. Not too thick, not too thin, just seems to be a nice middle ground between the two of them. So really, really nice, comfortable, secure upper. Now I said there's some, there wasn't supposed to be any change to the soul, but it feels like there was. The last version, the OG, which I happen to have right here, I love this shoe. It was a little stiff when warming up. It was not my favorite the first half mile or mile when I'm really stiff and trying to wake up. It just didn't feel like it moved very well. It felt like it was stiff, and it really took warming up for you to get that ride, for you to get that, engage that nice toe spring, that speed roll that they utilize. Whereas this one is slight, it feels like the whole sole is slightly softer. So that feeling of like, oh, it's just a little firm. I liked it when I picked up the pace here, but warming up was hard in version one. Version two, it's slightly softer. So it, and it's not just very slightly, it's subtle, but it's not that I don't really have trouble warming up in this. It transitions really nicely right away. This, there is a solid heel bubble, a little posterior flare, but this doesn't bother me at all. It feels like it compresses nicely. The whole sole feels like it gives a little bit more. So to me, this shoe doesn't feel as fast as last version. It feels more like a trainer, and it felt a little more comfortable warming up and for longer miles. I haven't really tried to pick the pace up in the shoe, even though I have 50 miles actually on this right now. Durability is doing awesome, by the way. And this is my left shoe, so this is pretty good. I ripped off this fairly early on the old version, but the stills lasted. This shoe has like 250 miles on it, but yeah, I expect good mileage out of this one as well. Outsole is very durable. It's handling it well, pretty much nothing after 50 miles, which is really good for me since I did tend to destroy shoes. No creasing in the sole that I'm seeing. Durability looks really, really good. So some slight sole changes. I don't think that was intentional, but it feels slightly softer. So it's a little easier to warm up in and a little bit less aggressive than the last shoe. Haven't tried to run fast in it, done a little strides. Really feels best as a long distance and recovery running shoe. Somebody maybe doing a road ultra marathon that just wants things that are not as aggressive, doesn't have a plate, this is going to be great. The speed roll, the toe spring is put in here perfectly. It's been really nice to unload my Achilles. I was worried that the 4 millimeter drop might bother this. Didn't bug it at all. You know, there is a 4 millimeter drop. You may not notice it because the shoe is rockered and the toe spring seems to take care of that toe off really well. This, it's put in a great spot. Saucony's really done their research. If you do toe spring incorrectly, it can mess this up. If it's too late, like certain other shoes, like the Adidas Adios Pro, for a really fast runner, that's going to feel great. If you have that toe spring really late, it feels like you're kind of going over a speed bump if you're running slower though. So again, this seems to be set a little bit back, set up nicely. The roll is phenomenal. It's great. They put it in the perfect spot. It's interesting to me that this shoe can create so much structure without being a quote unquote stability shoe. I mean, just like the last version, similar, but they do a continued good job, just like, you know, the heel, external heel counter, like I said, not as big as, you know, this version. The first one was pretty big. They toned it down, but it still does a very effective job of locking the heel in and guiding you through the gait cycle. The addition of the mesh on the lateral aspect, what was super flexible here, really helps guide you in. There's a lot of components here that make this a structured shoe, not a stability shoe. So those people who need a ton of posting, you probably aren't going to get what you need, but I think that this is going to work for the majority of people who need some kind of structure. The outsole, the last is a little bit wider, so there's some slight flare of the sole on all parts, but not enough that might create problems if you land forefoot or heel. It's just set up really nice that it feels like it's supportive without your post feeling that something jamming into your foot. I mentioned this in the last version that, you know, it's kind of reminds me of the Saucony Mirage. I don't feel this at all. It's not a post. It's just an extra piece of midsole. I don't even know if it's different. I'm curious to know from Saucony if it is. It probably isn't. It's probably just coloring. But the way this is set up, there are some mild sidewalls here, which were present in the last version. It just locks the foot in there really nicely and just rolls you through, which this is, in my mind, how you do structure. A lot of people don't necessarily need something that's super, like, overly stabilized, but some people do. A lot of people need something more like this, where it's just a little, it's, you know, it's structure, it's locking the foot in, and it just allows you to get your miles in without having you think too much about the shoe. So again, what Saucony said was mostly an upper update. There's some small changes to the sole as well. I noticed this forefoot is just slightly more flexible, and that may have to do with the sole being a little softer, but it's just a smooth ride. This is not your tempo shoe. that would be more the speed. It's not your race day shoe. That'd be more of the pro. Unless you're doing a long road ultra, then you might want to consider this shoe. This is your daily training shoe. This is the shoe that supports you while you're training in things like the speed or racing in the pro. It's a great shoe and it's really nice, still very flexible and breathable upper. I'm just impressed overall. And I really like this design. They tone the external heel counter down, but still brings this down to provide a little bit of guidance, but it's not so biased that it's pivoting you one way because they've got some of that same component on the other side. So really good job, Saucony. I love the shift. It's a great shoe. It's been really awesome on my feet. Loving that the sole is slightly softer, so it has a little more give, so it acts more like a recovery and easy run shoe than the slightly more aggressive version one, very slightly. But yeah, good job overall. Great shoe. $140 is a steal for a decent running shoe these days, right? Most things are like $160, $180. $140 is great. And I'm curious to know what people think about the colorways. I like this. I like things that pop out and bother people. So clearly I like this. It's kind of interesting. You got, you know, the pro they went all out with. But yeah, just curious to know what people think. If what they're most excited for with the Shift 2, what they like most about the Shift 1. I'm really excited. Now, this shoe hasn't even come out yet. This video is, what day is this? May, we're in May. This shoe comes out mid-June. I'm already excited to see what they're working on next. So yeah, for those concerned, the Shift 2 has not been ruined. They still kept the essence here. Do not worry. Just slightly softer, more secure fit, same essence. So that's our review. Our video review of the Saucony Endorphin Shift 2. Please check back in. We'll have a full multiple tester written review coming up and very excited to share our thoughts. And I'm curious to see what the other guys think about this shoe. So keep watching on all the social media platforms. Bach is doing an amazing job as always of promoting us and getting the word out, getting some great stuff out. So keep an eye. We're on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok. I can't believe we're on TikTok. LinkedIn, Reddit, anything you can imagine, we're there. Check us out. We've got good stuff coming up. My life is going to get hopefully less crazy here, so I'll have even more time to get good stuff out. Keep asking us questions. They're good, and we'll have some great guests coming on pretty soon. Another, what to do? Awkward ending.